considering that we're in the game. it's setting boundaries. It's setting boundaries. It's setting down so that you proceed with what you need to. Can you set it down? Can you please take our seats? Councillor Mortensen, can you take our seats, please? Councillors, Councillor Morrison, take your seat, please. Can you all be seated? Thank you very much, Councillor Morrison.
Thank you, Speaker, for affording us the opportunity. The multi-party caucus is for each other. We can now continue with the business of the day. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's proceed. Honourable Councillors, today is the last ordinary council meeting, as I mentioned earlier, of Councillor D. Johnson. Can you surprise the Chief Executive? I follow this mission as a councillor in the city of Tswane, with effective from the 30th of September 2023. I therefore give councillors an opportunity to say their farewell messages to Councillor Johnson. I am now giving each political party 3 minutes for this purpose and in the following order. But at the same time, when we are done with the farewell messages, we will also send our condolences messages to the family of Aziz Mahmoud. We will give that opportunity. But I'll call the ANC and give you 3 minutes for the farewell speech. Thank you.
Speaker, thank you very much for this fine opportunity. Yeah, so can the howlers keep quiet then? For once, we're going to speak something positive about your own.
Councillors, you can't get noise when you're waiting for the meeting is proceeding. So when you come in, please don't make noise. Don't make noise, just come in. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Chairperson. And for this fine opportunity, I'd like to ask the African National Congress, which our colleague, who is Saul's house. Wish you well in his future endeavors. And won't you believe that the step that he has taken to pursue other interests, he will be a shining example in those choices that he would have made for himself and Trump's family. As members of the African National Congress that had the privilege to work with him, I must indicate that we've worked very well, although we're on the opposite side of the table. But what brought us together in our engagements was for us to advance the interests and aspirations of the people of the city. I equally had a fine opportunity when I heard of his assassination that I gave him a personal call just to wish him well. My dear brother, go well and make South Africa proud. Let us continue to fight and advocate for a non-racial, non-sexist South Africa, that where the people of different races we may differ from time to time and fight for our own coexistence, ensuring that we create the kind of South African society that's equitable. If you are going to go into business, I want to make an appeal that the kind of relationship that we've had and built over the number of years, please, as you engage with people of different color in those business interests that you make fancy, make sure that there's always a reflection of the level of consciousness that South Africa truly belongs to all of us, irrespective of our race. Wish you well, and may the good Lord bless you as you step out into the world of great opportunities in you.
Thank you very much, Yancy. Now I call the DA.
Thanks very much, Speaker. Darryl Johnston is not just a colleague, he's a friend. I remember the day that he was elected in that by-election. And the first thing that struck me was, of course, his wit and his intelligence. He introduced me to something called Life of Brian, Monty Python sketch, I could say, and that helped me to understand half of his references in conversation. I also know that he loves sailing, but as a friend, as a colleague, as a conversationalist, it was delightful to be with him, to serve with him in council. And of course, what will define his contribution to the city of Tshwane are those very difficult few months in which he held down, which is probably the most difficult Mako portfolio. Utilities includes water and electricity. It is massive. Most of our capital budget is spent in those two departments. A lot of our operational expenditure. And he took the position at a time when, not just in Tshwane, but in South Africa, our electricity and water and sanitation reticulation networks are in a state of decay due to underinvestment over many years. And it is an extremely difficult portfolio to hold amidst water leaks, power outages, load shedding. But I have to say that an important part of Darryl Johnston's legacy as member of the mayoral committee was his contribution towards the establishment of the energy task team, which has been carried through by the present mayoral committee and contains essential steps to get Tshwane the necessary energy independence from Eskom. For that contribution, I believe that Darryl Johnston should be remembered, and I hope that professionals like him, business people, qualified people who can do basically whatever they want outside of politics, that those folks will continue to serve in politics. Because we need that contribution, we need that hinterland that they bring, the experience, the knowledge of the outside world, because politics can very often be insular, and we represent folks on the outside of politics. So that is a very important contribution. I also just want to thank Councillor Masabella for his remarks to Daryl Johnston and John Lee. Very kind and patron. And then lastly, to wish Daryl and Councillor Johnston the best of luck in his future endeavours. Thank you, Fred, for your contribution that you've made to the city, and we will remember you kindly. Thank you.
Thank you, Executive Mayor. Now I call Jeff. We are giving farewell messages to Councillor Johnston.
No, thank you very much, Speaker. I think the EFF would like to just wish the Councillor well and hope that he was not bullied there by the caucus, because there is a pattern of edging that happens in that caucus. As the EFF, I think, we have the right to highlight such issues. But I think in brief, we just have to wish our colleague well and hope that whatever that is going to be busy with will become a success. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, FFS.
Thank you, Speaker. I thank you for this opportunity. I want to start by saying that Daryl Johnston and myself were opponents in the election in 2021. So I'm bidding a farewell to my opponent, but at the same time, we, after the election, found each other and we were working well together. We also, for a short time, we were colleagues in Jamaica, and I did have the necessary respect for Daryl. He earned his respect. It's not something that you just get. It's something that you must earn. And he earned his respect through the way he conducted himself, and he handled his portfolio. As the Executive Mayor has already mentioned, I think it's the most difficult portfolio that there is to run in these times that we are living in at the moment. So, that being said, thank you, Daryl, for the job that you did do. For the residents of the city, I know when we had some discussions, we said whatever we do, we need to do it for the best of all residents of the city. Thank you for that. Thank you for the way that you were also a worthy opponent, somebody that we actually became friends afterwards. At the same time, I want to take this opportunity to wish you the best of luck in your new venture, and also to congratulate you with the opportunity that has come your way, and we trust that you will have a well and a good future going forward. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Griffith Bros, and Congregation SA. Congregation SA.
Thank you, Speaker. Seems like when you're a preacher, you must be able to talk at any time. I think in a very short space of time that we worked with Councillor Johnston, I see him as a professional in what he was doing. We always had respect for him. He's always a person like MMC Grande is saying, you know, respect is earned. And wherever he goes, if he goes out into the business world, we wish him luck and we pray God's blessing over him. That whatever he do, whatever he finds his hand to do, let him be successful. And we bid him farewell from actually this time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Commissioner ACDP.
And then, Mr. Johnson, as an ACDP, we would like to say enjoy your retirement. And Eddie, do not forget that Jesus Christ is going to be some sort of we'll be preparing. And Jim would like to say, whatever what you do, don't forget that there is God within heaven. So now, anything that you started, you're going to start as from the next month. We say, let God be with you, and let your change be blessed. And whatever what you're starting, you must ask the Holy Spirit to be holding you on your side. On the as you can hear, everyone has been talking about you. You being a good man, it shows that some people here, if they hate your character, and they give you. So now, if you were ever, whoever who you're going to do, whatever you're going to do, and whoever you're going to meet in future, you must keep that character and still be a good man. We thank you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Speaker, I'll speak on behalf of all the minor parties. I have known Mr. Johnson for many years because he was a member of the board committee for 91 when I used to be a councillor there. And I was pleasantly surprised when a few years later, after I left the DA, that I saw him standing and being elected in 47 as a councillor in his own right. We lost contact after I left the DA, but he served in this council together with my brother. And anyone who knows my brother knows that he is a very difficult man to please. His reports of his colleague and I believe a friend, who became a friend, was always very good, and he held him in high regard. That for me is good enough. I think the term that for the few months that he served as the MMC for utilities, he did so with as much distinction as you can do under the circumstances and in the party in which he served. And for that, I doff my hat to him. I have personally sent him a message after he made known his resignation to wish him well, and I will do that publicly to say that I really honestly do believe that he will do well, being a hard-working person as I have come to know quite well. And I'm sure that if I had known that he was a keen sailor, we would have had more conversations than I wish him well. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Someone is translating me. He's saying, let me translate. He's saying the tone that you consider. He's saying the tone that you've been holding, whether it's the department that you've been working in, and then see. Also, in your future, where you are going as your life being, go well and continue with the good job that you are doing. That's the message that I hope I deliver the message well. I don't know. Thank you so much. Consideration of the minutes of the previous council. But before we go there, as I said, we'll be passing our condolences messages to Isis Fahad and the family of the ANC. And I'll give that opportunity now for councillors or for parties to send their condolences messages. Myself and the ANC.
Speaker, I'll just talk to former Minister Pahad get homage, remarks from Councillor Patel. We want to bid farewell to Zoleka Mandela, an activist of the cancer movement, a woman that was born from a royal family, but also a family of activists that ushered freedom in this country. Zoleka Mandela was just 43 years old, but she made life to look easy with the condition of cancer, which is known to be deadly. She undertook different treatments, but she continued to live a normal life until the last day when she was admitted in hospital to Msabu, and she gave in to this killer disease. And what we need to do is to make sure that this intervention, and we look out for our colleagues that are struggling with cancer. They get support. Last month when we were bearing Councillor Mogo, former Councillor Mogo and MC Mogo, she also had to give in to the killer disease called cancer. Yesterday we held a memorial service in Mabubani to bid farewell to former MMC Yod Hall, who passed on. He will be buried in Freiburg. He was MMC for Economic Development in 2006 and 2011. A businessman that has been trading in different activities, automotive, transport, construction, in his own regard, but also served the people of Tshwane without them. Speaker, we also want to congratulate Councillor Msolwane on his academic achievement. Yesterday, he went back to UNISA, where he was an employee for many years. A leader of Nehalo was yesterday conferred with an academic achievement. We want to congratulate him on that achievement and hope that it will inspire many others. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Representative.
Thank you, Speaker. In this moment of universal sorrow, we want to mourn the death early today, early yesterday, of struggle icon and activist, former Deputy Minister Aziz Bahad, and recognize the imprint that he has left on the lives that have been touched by him. His life and contributions to the anti-apartheid movement and the establishment of a democratic South Africa are worth celebrating and remembering. Born on December 25, 1940, Schweizer Reneke in the northwest province of South Africa. Aziz was a key figure in the struggle for freedom. His journey towards a free South Africa began side by side with his brother Isu, who tragically passed away in July. Bahad's activism led him to being banned by the apartheid government in 1964. In response to this oppression, he went into exile, seeking refuge in the United Kingdom following the Rivonia crime. During his time in exile, he played a pivotal role in developing the anti-apartheid movement in Europe. His efforts abroad helped raise international awareness about the injustices of apartheid and garnered support for the cause of a free South Africa. Bahad's commitment to the liberation struggle extended to his involvement in key political organizations. He served on both the National Executive of the African National Congress and the Central Committee of the South African Communist Party in the mid-1980s. His roles in this organization further underscored his dedication to achieving a democratic and equitable South Africa. One of Aziz Bahad's most significant contributions was his involvement in his secret discussion with the South African government. These discussions were instrumental in paving the way for the transition to a democratic state. His diplomatic skills and dedication to finding a peaceful solution played a vital role in the eventual dismantling of apartheid. Aziz Bahad's passing marks the end of an era in South African history. He will be remembered as a tireless advocate for justice, freedom and equality. His legacy serves as a testament to the people, to the power, perseverance, and diplomacy in the face of adversity. The warmth of this person, his personal traits and animation, made for a sweeping and intimate celebration of the gift of his life. We record our deepest condolences to his wife, Manjana, and members of the Bahad and Bahad families. Thank you very much.
steal from Councillor Mamimeko to start congratulating Dr. Yusuf for his achievements. As he is invited to myself and Councillor Alderman Mamimeko for giving that celebration after he being confirmed. I want to speak about the condolences to Dr. Bahad, who worked closely with the former president, Thabo Mbeki, when they were in exile in the United Kingdom when they were students. They came together to establish the branches of young people who were in England by that time and make sure that they continually engaged. As it's recorded in the book of former President Thabo Mbeki, the King decided when they met in his flat to continually discuss the policy documents that can be put into the new dispensation of the government. But then it was still in the 1960s, from 1963 to 1966, when they completed their first degree and Thabo Mbeki continued to do his master's at the University of Sussex. So those are the things that I have read. It's not that I know the man individually and the work that he did for South Africa as a deputy minister. We want to appreciate that and say thank you to the one, and thank you very much for this speaker.
Thank you very much, Jesus.
Thank you very much, Speaker. We would like to wish and congratulate former chairperson and the inaugural chairperson of the EFF, Councillor Benjamin Solwani, on his conferred with his degree in administration. We wish him well, and we believe that education is the key. We are inspired by the EFF to find one of us being conferred with such a degree. We also want to encourage that people to go back to school and ensure that at least they do get some level of education, because we'll never get public administration and governance right if we run away from education. And as such, we want to really congratulate him and wish the best. We, as the EFF, we want to also express our condolences and sadness on the passing of Aziz Bahad. The man was born in Southern Northwest in 1940. Bahad's life journey was deeply intertwined with the struggle for freedom, justice in South Africa. From very early on, Bahad was a committed activist who dedicated himself to the fight against apartheid in 1964 under the oppressive apartheid regime. He faced a ban that expelled him and had to seek exile in the United Kingdom. During his life in the UK, he assumed a pivotal role in nurturing and advancing the anti-apartheid movement across Europe. Subsequently, he assumed a pivotal role in a clandestine negotiation with the apartheid government and laid the groundwork for transition to democratic state. While Bahad's contribution to South Africa liberated the struggle was immeasurable, he continued to serve as an international diplomat who represented the nation on the global stage with distinction. His legacy is one of commitment, principle, equality, justice, and human rights, and his legacy will forever inspire us to continue with his journey, the journey towards more a just and equitable society. Our thoughts and prayers are with our family and friends who have been troubled and have to deal with a double blow as he's still grieving the loss of his brother, Yusuf Bahad, who also passed on earlier this year. May Bahad rest in peace, knowing that his contributions to the nation will be remembered and cherished for generations to come. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
honourable speaker, who would like to start off with congratulating Councillor this morning with these achievements. I wish him well in his political career, but also at the same time on his professional career going forward. The honourable speaker, our sincere condolences to Mr. Aziz Bahad, who was the former Member of Parliament as well as the former Deputy Minister for Foreign Affairs, and specifically to his family, his wife, and Gina, and then also our sincere condolences to the ANC, who have lost their comrade and a stalwart. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you very much, actually, you see.
Thank you, Speaker. On behalf of HDSA, I stand before you today with a heavy heart to offer our deepest sympathies. Aziz Bahad was a visionary and a dedicated individual whose impact reached far beyond his accomplishment. His tireless efforts as a diplomat, politician, and advocate for justice made an indelible mark on our society. His contributions to the struggle against apartheid and the subsequent establishment of the democratic South Africa will be forever regarded with reverence. Beyond his remarkable achievements, Aziz Bahad was a kind-hearted soul who touched the lives of countless people. His warmth, humility, and unwavering commitment to the betterment of our nation inspired us. Through his wisdom and guidance, he nurtured new generations of leaders, instilling in them the values of integrity, compassion, and perseverance. In this time of immense sorrow, our hearts ache alongside yours. We recognize that no words can fully ease the pain you're experiencing. Aziz Bahad's legacy will live on in our memories forever, reminding us of the incredible power of perseverance and the unyielding pursuit of justice. His contribution will continue to shape our journey towards a more inclusive and equitable society. To the Bahad family, may you find strength and comfort during this difficult time. Cherish the memories, love, and laughter you share with us, and draw upon those memories to guide you through victories. Know that you have our unwavering support as you navigate this painful journey of healing and remembrance. In closing, let us honor the life of Aziz Bahad, celebrating his remarkable legacy and continuing his work and renewed passion and dedication. May his soul find eternal peace and his labor forever be a blessing. And thank you. And just in that great speak, I would also want to extend our condolences to the Mandela family who have lost the Mandela. And we say that may his soul also find peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Peacekeeping.
We raise the offer of heartfelt condolences to Aziz Bahad, the ANC's stalwart, and his legacy as follows. May his soul rest in peace. Also, we offer our condolences to Zulaka Mandela, whose account of a long fight with cancer and hate for being a cancer victimist for a long time. So rest in peace. Also, we want to congratulate Councillor Supade for his achievement. We take example and may God bless him. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Speaker. On behalf of the minority parties, we would like to extend our heartfelt and sincerest condolences to the Aziz Bahad family. A committed patriot until the end, he devoted his entire existence to serving the people, selflessness, empathy, humility, and sacrifice. His unwavering commitment to his struggle against apartheid carried the flame of hope for millions who yearned for a democratic South Africa. Between 1994 and 2008, he was a member of Parliament. each time we amplify the voices of those oppressed by apartheid on the global stage. One of Mahatma's crowning achievements was his instrumental role in mobilizing the international community against the apartheid South African government. His tireless efforts on this front contributed immensely to laying the groundwork for global consensus in apartheid had no place in the modern world. May his soul find eternal peace and may his legacy continue to inspire generations to come. Our heartfelt condolences go out to his dear wife, his brother, children, granddaughter, and extended family members, as well as his friends, comrades, and colleagues who share in his extraordinary journey. Thank you, Speaker.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Speaker. Also, thank you both.
Thank you very much.
Speaker, as actually saying, we are very much concerned with the conduct of the chief of the council in terms of processing leave applications. Each time when actually saying file a leave, it means that a particular council is unavailable. And it's mandatory for the chief of council to accept that leave. Speaker, in the previous minutes of council, where our councillors have filed leave applications, this reflect as absent. Whereas we've submitted leaves on time, and then the chief whip does not give us any reason why is he not approving our leaves. Speaker, I put it to council that the chief whip must put it on record that which procedure is he using to approve leaves. Cannot just wake up if he feels like he does not approve leaves. He does as he please. He must exercise his
council. Thank you, Council. We have 1 minute. And if they see.
Don't assist me. I don't need your assistance. I know that the council, again, I know that he has not finished. No, just quiet. Keep quiet. Keep quiet. I know that he's not finished. I am giving back his time. Just keep quiet. Keep quiet, consider for a host. Thank you. Finish up, consider.
Thank you, Speaker. So, the chief whip must put it on record to this House that which procedure is he using to approve leaves. I mean, he's elected in this council, and then he must exercise his council duties without fear or favor or any otherwise. Thank you, Speaker.
Thank you very much. I want to explain something before I can give you to speak. I noted you, noted you, Chief Whip, I noted you. We are speaking of the minutes of the 31st of August, where the councillors were all in here. So, the minutes of the continuation, that's where the action and school councillors were not here without any leave form that were submitted. That is the continuation of the 12th of September, the meeting that were online. And on that day, we did not receive any leave of application or leave of absence from the members, from councillors of Action SA. I just wanted to make it clear that you must argue on the right minutes, not on the minutes of the 31st. Okay, before I can come to you, Alderman Honorable.
Well, thank you. Yeah, this man is not so great. Called Marcelet. Speaker, we are talking accuracy of the minutes. HMSA debates leave police. It doesn't go like that. They must take the matter to withdraw so that they can get space to debate and argue the leave police. But now we are on the accuracy. Whether your name is there or not there. But if the chief will mistreat you about the leave police, take it to be fine. I do this only here.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think that is clear, Councillor Force.
Let me speak, thank you. Speaker. You know, mine is on you. Don't just decide to mute somebody without even giving them a reason. Now the government has been speaking alone, and you've been looking elsewhere. That is not in order, Speaker. Can you please, in the future, at least let the person know, hang in there a bit, unlike just putting them on mute? Voice me, and when you feel like resuming back to them, do that, you do so. Please, let's respect.
Let's move to continuation council 12th September 2023. Honorable councillors, I now put to you the minutes of the continuation council meeting of the 12th September 2023 for approval. Approved. Okay. Councillor Mnama and then Councillor Horsey.
Thank you, Speaker. I raise my hands before you go to the minutes of continuation. You didn't recognize me. I wanted to make a submission to say the minutes is not correct. MMC Debray, on the meeting of the 31st of November, she was not absent. She put a leave of
August. So from here all day.
My apologies, Speaker. The 31st of August, she was not absent. The leave was submitted, so this is not a true reflection of the minutes. Thank you. It needs to be rectified.
that can be corrected. The secretary is not taking note on that. Councillor Fosse. We are on the minutes of the 12th now, and I'm sorry, Councillor Mnami, for not recognizing you. Again, why do you think I'm blocking you if you are an alien? Why?
You like blocking, but it's fine, Speaker. Well, Speaker, we are not against you. We just bring it to your attention the issues that are clearly in these minutes. Baba Mwana was already in contact again. Well, the minutes are wrong.
I'm taking a point of order.
I'm not putting a point of order, I'm waiting.
That's not a point of order that you're putting.
No, thanks, Speaker. In terms of simple rules, you can't participate in minutes where you are absent. Councillor Fosse was not there on the continuation meeting. You can't speak to those minutes. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And that is the truth. There's no way that you participate in the minutes that you're not present. You're going to continue to speak. You complain like a child.
Okay, no, thanks, Speaker. Speaker, the minutes are reflected.
Okay. Point of order. Point of order.
Speaker, Alderman Maluleka raised a point of order. You agreed with it. I don't see why we're going back to the latter speaker was not of order. You can't be attending a meeting through oxygen or by another spirit. He was not there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Speaker. Speaker, I'm just raising on a point of order on your behavior that you must exercise all forms of restraint to call another councillor to be a child, to behave childish, and throwing your tantrums is unbecoming. Please respect all of us in this council and maybe apologize to the same councillor when you lost your time. Failure to do so, I would prefer your behavior to restrain.
Point of information.
Councillor,
Speaker, I'm raising one point of information that hopefully you will indulge me. I am sitting here in this August house, and my sitting here is very difficult. While people are wasting time, myself as a ward councillor, and I want to believe that I'm speaking on behalf of other ward councillors, perhaps the situation will be different from the other side. When you have convened us here, and we're going to spend the whole day in our communities that elected us, there is no service delivery at all. And I'll give you reasons why there is no service delivery. That's why I'm requesting you to give me enough time to explain myself while other people are wasting time for this. There is no service delivery because of the current material conditions in our state. One, in order for us to have any service, form of service delivery in this city currently as we speak, either from water and sanitation, electricity, waste management, or roads, or be whatever department, there must be security following those service delivery agents. Now, the executive have technically and cleverly removed security in townships. Where I come from in Mamelodi, Region 6,
Cancer. We are on the accuracy of the meeting. I will.
Tsega. Councillor Tsega. Councillor Tsega. Councillor Tsega. Are we allowed to finish up? Now, Tula Councillor Tsega. It's not you who's speaking. Finish up, Councillor Marshall.
Current speaker, for any service delivery to take place, the agents must be secured. I will give an example. For the past 5 weeks, because of lack of security, I was escorting waste plants that have been working in my ward and other agents in the ward environment for them to be able to do work. When you accompany them to the landfill site, they take anything between 10 minutes to 15 minutes to go and dump and come back. During that period when I'm standing there, I encountered not less than 8 Metropolis vehicles escorting trucks that are working in Pretoria East suburbs, transporting Windows, Citroën, and so on. Some of the Metropolis vehicles are migrated from other regions, Region 1, Region 2, to come and work there.
With Pretoria,
speaker. In the depot from electricity, the workers that are supposed to come and work in Mamelodi, they don't come unless until we fetch them as what cancels through the means that was made to secure them, including water and sanitation, sewer, and other departments. And this decision speaker is taken from by the coalition government that said, yet they come here and raise fevers.
This point of information is becoming a speech. So what I will ask you to do, what you are raising it now, can you write it to my office? Please. Councillors, why? No, it's a point of information that is becoming a speech. So can you please write it to me? The only the information that you are giving me, then I will take it from there. So I'm asking you to allow us to continue with the meeting on that point.
Okay. Speaker, you were in sexual relations. The very same issues that I'm facing with you here are the very same issues that were raised in Councillor Marshall or Councillor Tabak. So you are very much aware of the situation that I'm talking about. The reason why I'm raising this speaker, it's because we have convened us here in this meeting and people are wasting time. Technically, it means in 70 words, there's nothing that is happening while we are here.
Thank you, Chris. Councillor, please sit down. Councillor, may you please sit down. Sit down, Councillor. Please, may you sit down. Thank you.
Thank you very much. If you can allow us to continue with the meeting, I think it would be very, very, very nice if you can allow us not to dance in one place, because we're only on the minutes. So, and it is a fact. It is a fact that if you were not part of the meeting, I know it is a fact. I will give you a possibility to speak. It is a fact. Okay, point of order.
Speaker, I want you to respect the ruling that you have made on the minutes. It's a true reflection to those who also what Councillor Mahlangu said, those who want to dispute the process, they can follow the process. Then you stick to your ruling. We move to the next item on the agenda. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Can we then move to the item? Yes, yes, Councillor.
Thank you, Speaker. Just on the accuracy of the minutes, I think we still on that point. If my memory serves me correct, I don't address the council on item 15. It's on page 46 and 47 of the minutes. Thank you, and that's what you've been able to do. Thank you, Speaker.
Thank you very much. Now we are moving to reports to council. And now give to the executive mayor. Executive mayor. Okay. That's it. MS.
Thank you, Speaker. Just for the accuracy of the minutes, we want to be supplied with a reason why our leave was turned down when we applied in time and we said that we're going to be in a conference. Can it be on record, please?
Okay, point of order. Point of order.
Yeah. There were chances. All right, no, Speaker, thank you very much. Point of order, Speaker, is on the gentleman. We cannot have a situation where we are repeating ourselves on the issue. This is not a forum for us to discuss whether your leave was approved or not approved. They must take that complaint to the relevant personnel, to the chief whip's office, and then if they can't handle it there, they must send it to us as the whip will deal with it. But the HLSA cannot hold us ransom. And then the chief whip also must not entertain such things because it is going to degenerate and we are all going to come and dispute the leave policy in this house and how are we going to be able to run council effectively. HLSA must not do what they are doing to us. Thank you.
Speaker, I just want to clarify this. I discussed it with the leaders of the FCDC, the caucus leader, and the body that this, on the minutes, it is correct to indicate that they were absent. But after the meeting, I reversed my decision and I approved it. But that cannot be included in these minutes. But I tried to explain it to them, but it seemed to me they don't understand. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can I then for sorry, councillors? Can I close this? Can I close this by saying no. Can I close this? Thank you, councillors. Thank you. Can I close this by saying to the HLSA, can you meet the chief whip? Can you meet the chief whip? That is my decision. We are moving on now. Can I call the executive mayor to present the report? Councillor Rutukwane.
Speaker, can I proceed?
Oh, thank you very much, Speaker. I think it's a replacement. My hand was up, Speaker, just that I called a point of order because of what the other councillor was saying, the MNCO. So, Speaker, we are requesting a 1 hour determinate caucus break. That's the EFF. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can I allow the executive mayor to deliver the report? And secondly, I'm not going to give you 1 hour 30 minutes. I'll give you 1 hour. Not 1 hour 30 minutes. So can I allow hour, 30 minutes, 1 hour caucus that I'm giving you. Because we need to finish the work, councillors. We need to finish the work. No, 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 I will recognize you. I'm not talking to them. I'm not talking to them. Noted. Councillor Matukwala.
Yeah, thank you, Speaker. We are noting with concern the tendency to reduce and amend the caucus breaks of the EFF, which is totally unfair because when those races, the other side, are asking for leave, for caucus breaks, they do not get questioned like we get questioned. We are not stepchildren of this house, and it is unfair, and we've noted it, and even in our caucus, it has been highlighted that it's not the first time you amend the caucus breaks of the EFF, which is totally uncalled for, and it is becoming a tradition that you are dealing with. But lastly, the caucus break we are asking for is to resolve the mess that Bridges put us in. There are workers that are marching here, and we want to ask the workers of the city of Tshwane, including the councillors, and everybody else to join that march outside and be held accountable and make sure that the workers' demands are implemented. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Councillor.
Speaker, it's uncalled for, and it has become a culture whereby when the EFF members speak in this council, they speak as they like and point members to be racist. That is uncalled for, and it can never be allowed to continue. And you have never told them to stop doing that. They must stop that. They must stop those shenanigans. We cannot tolerate to be abused verbally in this council by members of the EFF. The members of the EFF cannot...
Councillor Matukwala. Thank you. I will allow the executive mayor to table her report.
In the absence of your ruling, Speaker, I refer Councillor Matukwala to Rules and Ethics and refer yourself for refusing to rule on my point of order. Thank you.
Speaker,
we the first ones to report the request, the few minutes to go out. So the mayor must not table his report first. He must go and engage the employees outside to hear their problems.
We don't have many God here.
Yeah, so let us be the first ones to go out and say, and then the mayor must wait. He's going to talk after you come back. Not this thing of this. And the report doesn't say anything about workers. It's a poor entertaining white people day in the hospital team.
Thank you very much. But let's agree on this. If I've made a ruling, let's continue with that. And without calling each other names, names that are not right, names that are not supposed to be called. So please, let us not do that. Now, I'm calling the executive mayor to present the report, and after that, I grant the caucus, 1 hour caucus, for election for EFF. Hey. Listen here. I'm the speaker, I'm the chairman, I decide where you go for lunch. Not yourselves. Executive mayor, your time is now.
Good morning, Honourable Speaker, Honourable Chief Kekana, his entourage, Honourable Chief Matanga, his entourage, Chief of Council, members of the Mayoral Committee, leaders of political parties, Honourable Aldermen, councillors, distinguished guests, City Manager, officials, members of the media,
course, the residents of our city. I share the congratulations and condolences expressed in your opening remarks, Speaker, and just want to highlight two important aspects of this council agenda. The first is that the number one priority of the capital city must remain to get out of financial distress. We've got to ensure that our income matches our expenditure, that our expenditure is within what we can reasonably collect. And of course, we've got to fix the systems and controls that ensure proper collections and value for the money that people pay for rates, services, and charges. Of course, we've got to always remember that this is not the municipality's money, but the money of the residents and the people broadly of the country. If we fail with this important objective, Speaker, it won't just affect the operations, the service delivery, the future of the city. Of course, those are the obvious implications. But we'll also not be able to improve our credit rating so that we can borrow money at affordable rates, so that we can build infrastructure that benefits the poor of this city. So, financial recovery is not just a luxury and nice to have, it is absolute necessity. To ensure that there is a relief of our financial situation, that we stabilize the finances, there is a report on this council agenda requesting debt relief offered to municipalities in terms of escrow debt, but subject to certain conditions which will be discussed in the debate. In essence, Speaker, there are certain risks that the city cannot afford to take. We can't change the basket of free basic services offered to the poor as accepted in our budget. We can't reduce that basket. We can't risk losing control of the city's distribution network. And we can't risk losing our ability to go out to the market to source funding. These are all functions that the Constitution assigns to every government and to the city, and we must guard it. But I do believe that there is space for us within those conditions to approach National Treasury for this debt relief. And it's important that we do it this month because we're reaching the expiry date of that particular offer. Secondly, Speaker,